Welcome, 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 welcome to Blessings and Breakthrough at Haitian Kings of Comedy, Comedy Joyride and Holy Fire International, where the Lord Jesus Christ will provide his word and message to be spoken through his servant, Minister Mackinson Lewis, for you tonight.
Yes, welcome out, welcome out, welcome out. My worship is on replay.
Yes,
Queen, that's the title.
Actually, notice.
Okay.
Notice by Ada Ehi.
Yeah, and the song says my praise is on replay. Understand that? You know what it means when a song is on replay. That means it doesn't stop. It's in cycle. It keeps going. So that's what I'm going to encourage you tonight, to put your praise on replay. Put your worship on replay. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because the Bible says pray without ceasing. That means that you're supposed to be in continual communication with God. You're supposed to continue and converse with God. You're supposed to stay in communication with God. Hallelujah. So that means that worship, put it on replay. Don't just worship once. That praise, put it on replay. Don't just praise God once, put it on replay. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes, amen.
So that's how we're going to start the week. That's how we're going to start the week. Understand that. We're not going to worship based on what's happening around us. Because once you worship based on what's happening around you, that means your mood control your worship. That means your mood control your praise. I worship God because he is God. So that means it doesn't matter what's happening in my job. He's going to get my worship. It doesn't matter what that paycheck is looking like. He's going to get my worship. It doesn't matter, you know, who's accepting my call, who's calling me, who's not calling me. He's going to get my worship. It doesn't matter who's coming in my life, who's walking out. He's going to get my worship. So my worship doesn't depend on anybody. It doesn't depend on any circumstance. It doesn't depend on my mood. It, like people, like the young people like to say, it doesn't depend on any vibe. It doesn't depend on anything, because I was created to worship. So God is going to get my worship. God is going to get my praise. My worship is going to be on replay. Hallelujah. So today I'm encouraging you to put that worship on replay. So that's another level of spirituality. That's another level of relationship with God. When the things around you don't affect your worship, when the things around you don't affect your praise, understand that. That's another level. So it's like, listen, I'm going to worship God no matter what. I'm going to pray and give God praise no matter what. I'm going to read my Bible no matter what. So now the spirit of distraction doesn't have authority over your praise. The spirit of distraction doesn't have authority over you reading the Bible. The spirit of distraction doesn't have authority over your one-on-one with God. Hallelujah. So that's what we are striving for. That's the level we're going to go at today. That is our promotion for today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if you are connecting with us tonight by the power of the Holy Spirit, I speak a spiritual elevation over your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now the devil will no longer have authority over your praise in Jesus' name. The devil will no longer have authority over your prayer life in Jesus' name. The devil will no longer have authority over your Bible study in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have been promoted by the power, woo, of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Welcome out. Welcome out. Welcome out. Understand that. You need to have that spiritual maturity for you to receive certain blessing. Because if you are a parent, understand that you're not going to give your kids your car keys because you have to see. It has nothing to do with age. I'm looking at your maturity. Do you have the maturity for you to partake of that blessing? That's the same thing God is looking at. If God is see that you are easily distracted, it's like, wait a minute, me giving you this blessing is going to pull you away from me because you don't have the spiritual maturity yet. Are you with me? So God have to see that spiritual maturity where, okay, the spirit of distraction doesn't determine how I worship God. The spirit of distraction doesn't determine how I pray God. The spirit of distraction doesn't determine if I'm going to read my Bible. So what's happening around me doesn't control me. I was created to worship. So when God see that, God say, okay, now you are ready for the next level. You are ready for this blessing. You are ready for this elevation. Hallelujah. Mm. Woo! So today I speak elevation over your life. So today I speak elevation over your life. Start smiling. Start smiling. You've been frowning too long. start smiling. Start smiling. You've been living a life of complacency for too long. Get excited. Get excited. Get excited about the God that you serve. Get excited about God's future for you. Get excited. Your best days are ahead of you because God is in control. God is the pilot of your plane. God is driving. God is in control of the steering wheel of your life. Hallelujah. Get excited. 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 Get excited about the God that you serve. Hallelujah. 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 You have been allowing your situation to control your mood. You have been allowing what's happening in your life to control your mindset. So now understand that you serve the one and only true living God. That's enough reason for you to get excited. You serve the one and only true living God. That's enough reason for you to be the most excited individual in your circle. Hallelujah. So start smiling. Start smiling. Start smiling. Hallelujah. We're going to start the work week off right. We're going to start the work week off right. We're going to start the work week off right. We're casting out the spirit of stagnation in Jesus' name. We're casting out the spirit of complacency in Jesus' name. We're casting out the spirit of sadness in Jesus' name. We're casting out the spirit of depression in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Because you know the magnitude of the God that you serve. You know the magnitude of the God that you serve. Call his name. Call his name. Call his name. That is the name that surpasses all name. That is the name that makes demons flee. That is the name that makes Satan tremble. Call the name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. He's in control of every single aspect of your life. He's in control of your health. He's in control of your marriage, your future husband. He's in control of your future wife. He's in control of your finances. He's in control of your health. He's in control of every single thing in your life that is associated with you. So give him his glory. Trust him. He got you. Hallelujah. 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 Faith and fear cannot occupy the same space. So you are either being led by faith or you're being led by fear. So today I'm encouraging you to get excited and start moving by faith. I'm encouraging you to get excited to start moving by faith. God got you. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Yes. You could choose to move by fear, but I choose to move by faith. Hallelujah. 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 That's why you see certain people are petrified with coronavirus. Certain people are fearful of coronavirus. Hallelujah. 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 So today I'm encouraging you to put all your faith in God. Once all your faith is in God, now you cannot have faith in sickness. You cannot have faith in COVID-19. You cannot have faith in death because all your faith is in Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm encouraging you to put all your faith in Jesus Christ. Where you have no more faith left. You have no more reverence left because you have given all to Jesus Christ. That's what I've done. So that's why I'm not impressed with COVID-19. That's why I'm not impressed with coronavirus. That's why I'm seeing people panic. I'm seeing people fearful. I'm like, listen, all my energy, all my faith go to Jesus Christ. Not a hair on my head will fall because he's in complete control of my existence, my entire being. So understand that. Understand that. Jesus said in Mark 9, verse 23, all things are possible for those who believe. So if you are believing in death, understand that you are giving death power. If you are believing in sickness, you are giving sickness power. If you are believing in poverty, you are giving poverty power over your life. Jesus said, my plan is to prosper you. My plan is to prosper you. So you could choose to believe that, or you could choose to doubt and start putting your faith in lack. I choose to believe that God's plan for me, like he said, is to bless me, is to give me a future, and is to prosper me. I will not move in fear. I will not live in fear. So I'm encouraging you today to get excited and trust God wholeheartedly with your future. Trust God wholeheartedly with your family's future. Hallelujah. And I'm not just talking about one single aspect, but I'm talking about every single aspect. I'm talking about your health. I'm talking about your finances. I'm talking about your marriage. I'm talking about your family. Understand that. I'm talking about your mental health as well as your physical health. Hallelujah. 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 Because Jesus said, I do not give you a spirit of fear. Mm-mm, that doesn't come from God. I give you a spirit of power, love, and sound mind. So once you see things that are manifesting that are opposite of love, power, and sound mind, you know that is the enemy working. So what's the opposite of love? You start feeling indifferent. You start feeling hate. Understand that, okay, that is not of God. A lot of you have been feeling indifferent. Indifferent. You're just going through life. That's the opposite of love. You know, that it's indifferent. You're on autopilot. It's like, you know what? It is what it is. No, that's not of God. God called you to live a life of love and passion, and for you to be excited about life. So understand that. You start seeing the spirit of confusion coming upon you, creeping up on you. God say, wait a minute, I give you a spirit of sound mind. You cast that out in Jesus' name. You cast that out in Jesus' name. You're finding yourself getting angry. That's not of God. Somebody cut you off. You're getting upset. That's not of God. You cast that spirit out in Jesus' name. Understand that. The enemy's after your joy. You got to hold on to your joy, because the joy of God is the source of your strength. Understand that. So the enemy would love for you to get angry. The enemy would love for you to, you know, get discouraged. The enemy would love for you to get fall into depression, for you to lose it, for you to lose your joy, your sound mind. Hold on to it. Hold on to it. So the things that are supposed to get you upset, say, I bind that in Jesus' name. Somebody cut you off, bless them. God bless you. God bless you. And you will see that the spirit of anger no longer have authority over your life. So now every single tricks and techniques that the enemy is using is not going to have power over your life anymore. It's not going to work. Why? Because Satan's objective is to pull you away from God. Satan's objective is to stop you from worshiping. Satan's objective is to stop you from praising. So now if everything that he's doing is not working because you continue on worshiping, he's defeated. If Satan's actions is not stopping you from glorifying God, he's defeated. So today I'm showing you the secrets to defeating Satan. You stay focused on God and you worship him no matter what. You stay focused on God and you praise his name no matter what. So that is how we are going to operate this week. That's how we're going to start our work week. Understand that. We're going to start our work week with praise. We're going to start our work week with excitement. We're going to start our work week with worship. We're going to start our work week filled up with faith and expectation, because we know God is in control of our future. God is in control of our life. It doesn't matter what the doctors say. It doesn't matter what my friends say. It doesn't matter what my family say. God is in control of my life. Understand that. So get excited about your future. Get excited about the God that you serve. Get excited. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because understand that. Jesus say, if you are ashamed of me, I will be ashamed of you. So understand that. How you move towards God plays a big factor on how he moved towards you. So you are excited about God, God is going to be excited about you. You make God a priority, he's going to make you a priority. So understand that. Understand that. So get excited. Get excited. Get excited. Get excited. All right, we're about to get into our prayer. We're about to get into our prayer segment. You can go ahead and start typing in your prayer. There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. Understand that. There's no God like Jehovah. Go ahead and type in your prayer requests. If it's health, type in health. If it's employment, type in employment. If it's marriage, type marriage. If it's family, type in family. Let's go. Let's go. We're about to get into our prayer requests. We're about to get into our prayer segment. We have been getting a lot of praise reports. Testimonies are coming in. The Holy Spirit is moving in a monumental way. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Glory to God, glory to God.
Amen, amen, amen.
We're going to start off our prayer segment with employment. Anybody who's dealing with financial issues, this prayer is for you. All you got to do is raise your hand in the air. All you got to do is raise your hand in the air and say, Lord, I receive it. Lord, I receive it. Woo. Don't look at your situation. Look at God. Look at God. Stay fixated on God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Don't look down. Don't look down. Look straight ahead. Those of you, you remember when you were learning how to ride a bicycle? What happens if you look down? You fall. What happens if you look to the right? You fall. You look to the left. You fall. Let's get back to the basics. Look straight ahead. Look straight ahead. Look straight ahead. Family, salvation, continuous peace and success. I see you. I see you, Jay. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. So just like you're riding a bike, understand that. What happens if you stop pedaling on the bike? What happens if you stop pedaling? You fall. So you have to keep pedaling. And that's why the scriptures say, pray without ceasing. Don't stop praying. That means you have to stay in communication with God. Just like when you're on a bicycle, you got to keep pedaling. You got to keep pedaling. If you stop pedaling, you're going to fall off. That means you have to keep worshiping God. You have to keep praising him. You have to stay in your word. You have to keep reading your Bible. You have to stay in communication. The scriptures say, pray without ceasing. It's because just like riding a bicycle, you can't stop pedaling. Because the moment you stop, you will fall. So all of these things have to be done continuously, just like riding a bicycle. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to start our prayer. We're going to start our prayer. Our prayer segment is going to start right now. Sister J, salvation for her family and continuous peace and success. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us go to the Lord. Because I don't understand how somebody, you could love someone and then you are comfortable with that person spending eternity in hell. I don't understand that. So I don't understand why more Christians are not asking prayer for salvation for their friends, for their family. How is it that you know you're concerned about this person's physical being, and meanwhile we only here for a short period of time, and your soul is forever. So you claim to love this person, but you're not concerned with this person's soul. You claim to love this person, but you're not concerned with that person's salvation. And understand that the amount of time that we spend on this earth is shorter than the blink of an eye when you compare it to eternity. But yet, you're not praying for your loved one's salvation. You're not concerned about their soul. So you don't know what love is. You don't know what love is.
Fact.
Until you start praying for the salvation.
Amen.
Of your loved ones, your family. I pray for the salvation of my enemies. Because I can't claim to have the Spirit of God in me, and then I am comfortable with my enemies burning in hell.
Amen.
Absolutely not.
Amen.
Absolutely not. And yet, you're not even praying for the salvation of your own friends and family. Something's wrong with that. Something's wrong with that. So let us go to the Lord. We are going to pray for salvation for the family of Jay, and we are going to pray for her continual peace and success, for her to stay on the path of righteousness, and for her to continue on walking and moving and operating with the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
For her to receive everything that God have for her.
Amen.
Because understand that majority of people forfeit their blessing. You see that with the Israelites when they left Egypt. Only a fraction of those people made it to the promised land. Only a fraction of a fraction. All the adults, out of the adults, Joshua and Caleb made it to the promised land. It's the same thing also. Most of us, we forfeit our blessing. So we're going to pray that doesn't happen. For you not to forfeit your blessing. Hallelujah. Let us go to the Lord. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, Lord, we lift Sister J before you, Heavenly Father, Lord. We lift Jada before you, Heavenly Father, Lord. We lift her family before you, Heavenly Father, Lord. She is asking for salvation for her family, Heavenly Father, Lord. She is asking for her salvation. And that is the most important thing you could pray for somebody for, Heavenly Father, Lord. It is more precious than gold. It is more precious, because you say, what good is it for a man to gain the world and lose his soul? So therefore, Heavenly Father, Lord, we know nothing is important if your soul is not saved. We are lifting Jada's family before you, Heavenly Father. We are lifting their soul before you, Heavenly Father, Lord. Allow them to have an encounter with you tonight. The same way Paul had an encounter with you, Heavenly Father, Lord, on the road to Damascus, where he was not able to deny your power. He was not able to deny your lordship. He was not able to deny that you are God all by yourself. And he had to surrender to you wholeheartedly. So we ask, Heavenly Father, Lord, for Jada's family to have the same encounter with you tonight, Heavenly Father, Lord. Allow
Amen.
Them to
yes,
see
Lord.
You. Allow them to feel you. Allow them to hear you, Heavenly Father, and for
Hallelujah.
Them to surrender to you, Heavenly Father, Lord. For them to see that this life is worthless without you. Oh, Heavenly Father, Lord, I lift every single individual, Heavenly Father, Lord, who fall under the sound of my voice. I lift their family before you. They may not know, Heavenly Father, Lord, the importance and the necessity for them to intercede on behalf of their family, Heavenly Father, Lord. But I do. So I'm asking you, Heavenly Father, Lord, every individual that fall under the sound of my voice, Lord, I speak salvation over the lives of their family, Heavenly Father, Lord. Touch them.
Yes, Lord.
Tonight, Heavenly Father, Lord, before the sun come up, allow them to have an encounter with you the same way Paul had an encounter with you, Heavenly Father, Lord.
Yes,
allow them
Jesus.
To feel the void, Heavenly Father, Lord, for them not to want to go on without you, Heavenly Father, Lord. For them to surrender their entire existence to you, their whole life, Heavenly Father, Lord. Not some, not most, but all.
Yes,
of their existence. Hallelujah. Amen. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the salvation of every single home that is represented here tonight. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, we lift Jada before you, Lord. We speak peace over her life.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
We speak peace, Heavenly Father, Lord, and success for your glory, Heavenly Father, Lord. Not for any other reason, but for your glory. Let others see her success and her elevation, and for them to say, I want to serve the God that Jada served. Hallelujah. The same way, Heavenly Father, what the devil was afraid of Joseph's elevation, of being the head of Egypt, because he knew the moment Joseph gets to that position, people were going to say, I want to serve the God that Joseph served, because they knew he served the one and only true living God. So therefore, Lord, we are coming before you, Heavenly Father, Lord, lifting Jada's calling, lifting her purpose, Heavenly Father, Lord, lifting her ministry before you, Heavenly Father, Lord, and asking that you bless it, Heavenly Father, Lord, for the glorification of your name and the expansion of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray.
Jesus'
Amen.
Name.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are worthy to be praised. You're worthy.
Yes,
you're worthy.
Lord,
you're worthy.
Jesus.
You're worthy. You're worthy. You are all that matters. The song says you are all that matters. We're casting out the spirit of distraction in Jesus' name. Whatever it is that is hindering you from surrendering your life to God wholeheartedly, completely, we're casting that out in Jesus' name. God is all that matters. God is all that matters.
Yes.
We're casting out the spirit of distraction. Oh, Lord, anything and everything that is interfering with your spiritual life, we're casting it out. In Jesus' name, we are casting out the spirit of laziness in Jesus' name. We're casting out the spirit of spiritual laziness in Jesus' name. Oh, Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah. Casting out the spirit of distraction. Whatever that's stopping you from putting time aside for you to have that one-on-one with God every single day, we are casting that out in Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, Lord, generational demons that are moving against you, that are interfering with your prayer life, that is making you sleepy every time you're about to read your Bible, that is making you fatigued and weary every time you're about to pray, we are casting out those spirits in Jesus' name. Demons
Jesus
from
name.
The Marine Kingdom, we are casting it out in Jesus' name.
In Jesus
those
name.
Of you who are tied up by spiritual spouses, you have spiritual husbands and spiritual wives that are tying you up, we are casting that out in Jesus' name. They are, that are preventing you from flourishing, that are preventing you from elevating, we are casting it out in Jesus' name. We are breaking all the demonic alliances that are over your life right now in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, those demonic spiritual spouses that are preventing you from getting married, we are casting them out right now in Jesus' name. Those demonic spiritual spouses that are destroying your marriage and pulling you apart from your husband, from your wife, we are casting them out right now in Jesus' name. Those generational demons that are destroying your finances, that's making you live paycheck to paycheck, money just fly out your hand, we are casting that out in Jesus' name. Continual problems that's stopping you from elevating, and you come from one problem to the next, Heavenly Father, we are casting that out in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, the spirit of self-destruction, every time God sends someone into your life and you find a way to sabotage that situation, you find a way to push people away, that is a demonic spirit that is stopping you from your elevation, we are casting that out in Jesus' name. All your generational demons that are interfering with your life, that are stopping you from moving in your calling, you have buried talents, you have buried potential, you are unable to operate in your calling, you're unable to operate in your purpose, we are casting out all these demons that are tying you up in Jesus' name.
In
hallelujah.
Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm speaking deliverance. Let all
Glory
the chains break over your life. Hallelujah. I'm speaking deliverance over your life. Hallelujah. Those witchcraft attacks that have been sent upon you due to jealous relatives, I'm speaking a deliverance over your life right now. Hallelujah. 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 All the attacks, let it go back to the sender. Hallelujah. 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 Tonight, you are delivered in Jesus' name. Tonight is your breakthrough. Tonight is your breakthrough in Jesus' name. Raise your hand in the air and say, I receive it. I receive it.
I receive it.
You see that you have not been living to your potential. You have your life has not manifested your intellect. It has not manifested your talent. It has not manifested your potential, your calling, your purpose. You see that. You're stagnated. You're stuck. You're nowhere near operating your potential. Demons have been tying you up. Generational demons, as well as witchcraft attacks from jealous family members, ex-lovers, neighbors, so-called friends. Tonight, by the power of Jesus Christ, you are delivered. I break all demonic attacks over your life. Hallelujah. Attack over your health. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Chronic pain. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You go to the doctor, but they don't see what anything wrong. But that pain doesn't go away. That discomfort, it doesn't go away. It persists. You'll get a brief relief and then it comes right back. I'm speaking deliverance. I'm speaking deliverance over your life right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. In Jesus' name. I cast out that spirit of pain in Jesus' name. I cast out that spirit of discomfort in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I speak a supernatural anointing over your health. Hallelujah. 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 I speak a breakthrough. I cast out all cells of sickness and diseases in Jesus' name. I cast out that spirit of complacency of just being stuck in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I speak elevation right now over your life. I speak breakthrough over your life right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I cast out the spirit of sadness in Jesus' name. I cast out the spirit of depression in Jesus' name. Oh, yes, 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 yes. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. You have suppressed that. You're trying to suppress that spirit of depression. You continue on operating, but deep down inside you are sad. Deep down inside you're unable to get excited about life. Deep down inside you feel like your best days are behind you. Deep down inside you feel like you've blown it. Today the Holy Spirit said you have not blown anything. All you need to do is surrender to God, and you will see God's power and glory manifest in every single aspect of your life. God is going to blow your mind. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Raise your hand in the air. Raise your hand in the air. Yes, I'm talking to you. Raise your hand in the air. You feel like a failure. You feel like a failure. You are crippled with insecurity. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Understand that. That is for a purpose. That is for a reason. God needed you to surrender to him. Because if God have allowed you to operate in your full potential, you would not feel the need to surrender to God. So you needed to feel that void. You needed to feel inadequate so you could surrender to God. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I'm casting out that spirit of insecurity over your life right now. I'm casting out that spirit of inferiority over your life right now. I'm casting out the spirit of rejection over your life right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I speak elevation. I speak spiritual breakthrough over your life. I speak a spiritual breakthrough over your life. I'm casting out all the demonic alliances in Jesus' name. I break all the demonic alliances, all the demonic covenant that's been made over your life in Jesus' name. I break it. I break it. I break it. All the demons that are moving against your finances, that are moving in your marriage, I cast them out right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Out, out, out. In Jesus' name. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Your deliverance is now. Your deliverance is here right now. Grab it. Grab it. Raise your hand in the air. Raise your hand in the air. Say, Lord, I am yours. I've done things my way. Now I surrender to you. Do with me as you will. I surrender to you. Hallelujah. And the devil has no authority over your life anymore. No demons have authority over your finances anymore. Amen. Demons have no authority over your health anymore.
Amen.
Get excited.
In Jesus' name.
Get excited. You are delivered in Jesus' name. Get excited. Get excited. You have not gotten excited about anything in a long time. You have been living a life of complacency in a long time. You have been living a life of stagnation in a long time. It's time for you to start smiling again. It's time for you to get excited again. God is here. The Holy Spirit is here. The Holy Spirit is moving in your life right now. Receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it. Your breakthrough is here. Hallelujah. 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 God is here. God is moving. God is moving. Everyone who falls under the sound of my voice, your breakthrough is here. Hallelujah. Now, you are breaking away from all the ungodly things that are moving in your life. You're breaking away from that adulterous relationship in Jesus' name. You're breaking away from that fornicating relationship in Jesus' name. You're breaking away from that habit of smoking in Jesus' name. You're breaking away from that habit of escaping through those glass of wine, feeling the need to feel nice. Because you don't call it being drunk. You call it nice. You call it feeling nice. We're casting that out. Now, your source of feeling nice is the Holy Spirit. Amen. Your source of breakthrough is the Holy Spirit. Your source of peace is the Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
It's not alcohol. It's not weed. It's not pornography. All of that is out in Jesus' name. All of that is out in Jesus' name. You surrendered. You surrendered. The spirit of laziness have no authority over your life anymore. You shall live a life of passion, diligence, and a strong work ethic that's going to glorify God. You shall live a life of discipline that's going to glorify God. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. You are delivered, you are delivered, you are delivered in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Amen, 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 amen. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ooh, yes, praise God. Praise God. We're going to pray for Haiti and then we're going to get into our sermon. We're going to pray for Haiti and then we're going to get into our sermon. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Ooh, I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I am so excited. I feel the presence of the Holy Spirit moving. Amen. I feel the presence of the Holy Spirit moving. Get excited. Get excited. Get excited. Get excited. Start smiling. Start smiling. Start smiling. Start smiling. The spirit of doubt got to go in Jesus' name. The spirit of doubt got to go in Jesus' name. I remember I was a kid in Haiti. Ooh, there was a lady who gotten delivered. She was blind. There was a lady that got delivered. And the Holy Spirit moved. Servant of God put hand on her. And her, she gained her sight. This woman couldn't believe that she was able to see. This woman opened her eyes and started looking around. And she completely was in disbelief. She kept on saying, I'm not supposed to see. Throughout the whole day, she said, I'm not supposed to see. The next day, she kept on saying the same thing. I'm not supposed to see. And on the third day, she said, I'm not supposed to see. And then she lost her sight again because she would not receive her miracle. She would not embrace her miracle. So understand that. Don't make that mistake. When God say this is yours, it's yours. Spirit of doubt got to go. Once God say it is yours, it is yours. The spirit of fear got to go.
Amen.
Whatever God have spoken over your life, it shall come to pass. He is God. Whatever comes out of his mouth, his hand will accomplish. So understand that. So what God spoke over your life, give him thanks, give him praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
There's no more room for doubt. I don't care what the doctor said. I don't care what your family said. If God say you are delivered, you are delivered. If God say you are going to be a doctor, I don't care if you used to be an F student. I don't care how poorly you used to operate in school. If God say you are going to be a surgeon, you are going to be a surgeon. If God say you are going to have a baby, you are going to have a baby. It doesn't matter what the doctors say. It doesn't matter what the tests say. God is not limited by logic. God is not limited by science.
Amen.
He created science.
Amen.
He has power and authority over everything and anything.
Amen.
So understand that. It's time for you to get out of God's way. Get out of God's way. You have been blocking your blessings long enough. You have been blocking your elevation long enough. Now we've got to pray for Haiti. And then we're going to get into our sermon. We're going to pray for Haiti. We've covered all the prayers. And now we're going to pray for Haiti. We are going to pray for Haiti to be the testimony of Jesus Christ. So now the world see what happened in Haiti. We have denounced God. We have aligned ourselves with our ancestors. We have aligned ourselves with demons. We have aligned ourselves with Satan. And we've given Satan so many years, centuries after centuries, and he has not been able to do anything for us. So now we are going to consecrate Haiti to Jesus Christ. And we're going to get out of God's way and watch God move on behalf of Haiti. Hallelujah. You're going to see what the devil couldn't do. You're going to see what demons couldn't do. You're going to see how God going to break Haiti free. Let us go to the Lord. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, Lord, we lift Haiti before you, Heavenly Father. We know, Heavenly Father, Lord, we as a people, since the days, Heavenly Father, that you've delivered us from Egypt, you said, Heavenly Father, Lord, all of these curses will come upon us because of our love for other gods, which is witchcraft. And we still have not learned. We continue on disobeying you. We continue on aligning with demons. We continue, Heavenly Father, Lord, on serving Satan, Heavenly Father, Lord. And we see the repercussions. We've seen the consequences over and over and over, Heavenly Father, Lord. The devil has not been able to bring anything in Haiti but pain, suffering, sickness, poverty, and humiliation. But Heavenly Father, Lord, we are surrendering to you now. We are consecrating Haiti to you right now, Heavenly Father. We cast out, Heavenly Father, Lord, Oh, the demonic spirits that are moving in Haiti, Heavenly Father, we speak salvation over Haiti and everyone in it. Lord. We speak Holy Spirit fire over Haiti and everyone in it, Heavenly Father. Let them have an encounter with you, Heavenly Father, the way Paul had the encounter, Heavenly Father, for everyone in Haiti, for them to say, we give our existence to Jesus Christ. We serve the one and only true living God, Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father, so your power and authority could move throughout the entire country so the world could see that you are the one and only true living God. For the world could say, if he could do that with Haiti, imagine what he could do with us.
Amen.
Oh, Lord, we glorify your name, Lord, for this testimony. We glorify your name, Lord, for the breakthrough of Haiti. We glorify your name, Lord, for the deliverance of Haiti, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, and we thank you for showing up and showing out and meeting Haiti at the crossroad of its needs. Lord, we praise your name. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, let a change happen right now, Heavenly Father. Let your power and authority, Heavenly Father, move out all the demonic forces right now in Haiti, Heavenly Lord. Arrest the environment, Heavenly Father. Take control over Haiti, Heavenly Father, and let your will be done and your name glorified in Haiti, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Amen,
hallelujah.
Amen,
hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Haiti belongs to Jesus Christ.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
I'm not impressed with demons. I'm certainly not impressed with Satan. Hallelujah. 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 Haiti belongs to Jesus Christ. 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 A delight. I see you, woman of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sister Jacques, now I see you, woman of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We're closing out our prayer segment. We're about to get into our sermon. So it's about that time where you want to grab that Bible. It's about that time when you want to grab out that notepad. We're about to dive into the word. We're going to be quick. But the sermon is only short in length, not in power. Understand that. Get ready. The Holy Spirit is going to speak to you. The Holy Spirit is going to move through you. The Holy Spirit is going to speak to you and move through you. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. The Holy Spirit have a word for you tonight. The Holy Spirit have a whole anointing word for you tonight. Get ready. Mm. Get ready. Get ready.
All right, all right. The verses, the scriptures reading that will be for tonight is in Daniel chapter 3, verse 28 to 30. That's Daniel, the book of Daniel, chapter 3, verse 28 to 30. And the word of God goes like this. Nebuchadnezzar spoke, saying, blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sent his angel and delivered his servants who trusted in him. And they have frustrated the king's word and yielded their bodies that they should not serve nor worship any god except their own God. Therefore, I make a decree that any people, nation, or language which speaks anything amiss against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be cut in pieces, and their houses shall be made an ash heap, because there is no other God who can deliver like this. Then the king promoted Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the province of Babylon. The word of God. Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The title of our word for tonight is The Power of Representing the Kingdom. The Power of Representing the Kingdom. And we're going to dive right into it. Understand that when you represent God the right way, people are going to get delivered through you. And the king saw how Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego operated, and he said right away that they serve the one and only true living God. They made a believer out of the king. So understand that you have the power and the ability to make believers out of your co-workers. You have the power and the ability to make believers out of your neighbors. You have the power and the ability to make believers out of your neighbors. You have the power and the ability to make believers out of your own enemies. Because understand that the king was getting ready to kill Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. So if somebody's trying to kill you, that would constitute that individual as your enemy. So I am not exaggerating when I tell you that if you serve God the right way, if you represent the kingdom the right way, not only will you deliver yourself, but your enemies are going to be inspired and say, I want to serve the God that he serve. I want to serve the God that she serves. So understand that a lot of people are going to go to heaven because of you, because of your action, because of how you are representing the kingdom. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. So today I need to ask you, evaluate yourself. Make an assessment. Make an inventory over your life. How are you representing the kingdom? Are you satisfied with the way you are representing the kingdom? So understand, if you are panicking the same way the world is panicking, they don't need to look for you for answers. So if the world is afraid of COVID-19 and you're afraid of COVID-19, so therefore we are on the same boat. If the world is afraid of death and you are afraid of death, that means we are on the same boat. If the world is cursing and you're cursing, that means we are on the same boat. If the world is lusting and you're lusting, we are on the same boat. If the world is living in fornication and you're living in fornication, we are on the same boat. If the world is into adultery and you're accepting adultery, we are in the same boat. Hallelujah. But when you stand for righteousness, when you say, I will not align with what's happening on my right, I will not align with what's happening on my left, I will keep my eyes fixated on Jesus, I will keep my eyes fixated on the heavenly kingdom, now they're going to say something's different about this individual. Now they're going to say something is unique about this individual. So now when everyone else is listening to this vulgar music, you're like, no, that's not for me. I don't listen to that kind of music. When people are talking about this artist, you go, no, the artist that I listen to, they glorify God. So you got to understand, you have to put yourself aside in character. And putting yourself aside, it doesn't mean that you stand offish. It doesn't mean that you put your nose down on everybody else. It doesn't mean that you are arrogant. It means that you walk with the power and the glory of Jesus Christ inside of you. So you are in this world, but you're not of this world. Hallelujah. So now the way that you talk has to glorify God. So you're not out there cussing and cussing. You're not out there having vulgar conversation. You're not out there talking about raunchy sex, swapping sex toys at work. Hallelujah. It means that I need to glorify God. It means that my body is a vessel for God. It means that the words that come out of my mouth got to glorify God. Yeah. It means that the actions that I partake got to glorify God. That's what it means. That's what it means. So now people are going to look at you and say, this person is different. Now you are going to inspire them. You got to understand that when they see you stand for righteousness, hey, you have the opportunity for you to lie and make some money over here, you go, no, I cannot disrespect my God like that because he provide for me. Now your coworkers are going, that person is different. So understand that. I remember I did a show at SOB's and I told the owner, listen, if I'm going to do two shows and if both shows don't sell out, I will give you all the money that goes through the door. Hallelujah. I serve the one and only true living God. I speak in the name of Jesus. I did the first show. Every seat in the house was taken. Woo! Now the second show came. We had a great turnout, but all the seats were not taken. Now they are looking at me. Now am I going to be a man of my word? And I went downstairs at SOB's in Manhattan. All the money was on the table. I said to the manager, that's not my money. That is your money because I gave you my word. I am a man of my word. I serve the one and only true living God. I said, if I did not sell both shows back to back, all the money's yours. Well, guess what? All the money is yours. Now they know that I serve the one and only true living God because money don't excite me, because I am a man of my word. It means that I will not lie. It means that I stand for righteousness. I stand for the truth. So now this Jewish man is looking at him, going, looking at me, going, this man is different. These Jews, this Ashkenazi Jews are looking at me going, this man is different. What God does he serve? Oh, he served Jesus Christ. Wow. I've never seen anything like that before. The same way the king Nebuchadnezzar looked at Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and said, I've never seen anything like that. People have to look at your life and say, I've never seen anything like that. The way you walk, the way you talk, the way you carry yourself, people have to say, I've never seen anything like that. You got to glorify God in everything that you do. You have to glorify God with the way you speak. You have to glorify God with the way you eat. Understand that before I get into the diet, how do you speak? I'm not talking about when you're in a good mood. I'm talking about when somebody cuts you off. They flipping you the finger. They yelling out obscenities to you. They are cursing at you. What are you doing? Are you cursing that person back? Are you getting angry? Or are you glorifying that person's name? So understand that. If somebody cuts you off, they roll down the window and they yell out obscenities to you. You tell that person, God bless you. Jesus love you. Woo! You just attack the demon that's inside that person. Amen. Now this person got to go home and think about that. The mistake that we made, we align ourselves with the demon that's in that individual. You curse at me, I'm going to curse at you back. Or you must not know who I am. You must not know about me. Now you're about to know about me. Well, I'm going to tell you who you are since you forgot who you are. You are a child of God. You are supposed to represent God at all times. You are not supposed to represent your anger. You are not supposed to represent your animosity. You are supposed to represent Jesus Christ and utilize that situation to minister to somebody. Hallelujah. I hope I'm talking to somebody right now. I hope I am talking to somebody right now. A lot of you have not gotten this. That's why you have not received your elevation. That's why you remain stuck financially. That's why you stay at the place that you are. You need to start representing God in every situation. And when God see that, now he's going to elevate you. God doesn't just elevate anybody. God is an investor. So he look at where he's investing. Are you ready for this blessing? Are you ready for this miracle? So now if you are not representing me properly, if you're not representing the kingdom thoroughly, you're not ready. So today, that's the way you show God that you are ready, by representing him in every single aspect. You need to represent God in every single aspect. How you speak, how you carry yourself, how you eat. Yes, I said it. How you eat.
Amen.
How are you a Christian? How are you a servant of God where your body is a temple and you're eating junk food? I forgot the word junk. For those of you who don't know, it means trash. So unless your body is a trash can, you are not allowed to be eating junk. That's a sin. So therefore, you have an obligation to take the very best care of your body. You're not supposed to be waiting for a doctor to give you some form of diagnosis for you to start eating healthy.
Right.
You're not supposed to be waiting for a doctor to give you certain diagnosis for you to start exercising. You serve the one and only true living God, and your body is a temple. So therefore, you have an obligation to take the very best care of your body. You have an obligation to make the best food choice for your body. Never mind what tastes good in the mouth, but what is going to do good for my body.
Amen.
What am I going to partake that's going to glorify God? So that's how you're supposed to move. So now instead of drinking that soda, I'm going to drink some water. Instead of eating that McDonald's, I'm understanding, I'm going to get me some fruits. I'm going to get me some vegetables. Hallelujah. Instead of just sitting on a couch, I'm going to start putting some time aside for me to exercise. You don't need a gym membership for you to exercise. So there's no excuse for you not to exercise. You could exercise at home. You could do some push-ups at home. You could do some sit-ups at home. Understand that those preachers cannot preach on this subject because majority of the black preachers are fat and out of shape. So you can't preach on something that you're not living. You cannot preach on something that you're not living. So they are morbidly obese. So therefore, our majority of black people now, we are ignorant in nutrition. We don't think that we have an obligation to take care of our body. Understand that taking care of your body is not a plus. It's a must. Exercising is not a plus. It's a must. I bet you've never heard that from a preacher before. I bet you've never heard that from a pastor before. And I'm here to let you know that. Your body's God's temple. So therefore, how can you say I serve the one and only true living God and you do not have discipline with the food that goes in your mouth? You are morbidly obese. So what is the difference with someone if you have a food addiction or a drug addiction? Both of you are using something to escape. How dare you look down on the crackhead? You have a drug too. Your drug is just food. So the same way he can't control getting high, you getting high off of food. You're not fooling me. Lack of discipline on both ends. He chooses drugs to get high. You choose food to get high. I know I'm going to lose some people on that one. I know some people are definitely going to come back. Wait a minute. You know what? I was riding with him, but I'm not riding with him anymore.
Hey,
I know I just lost a couple of people. I know a couple of people just signed off right now. I know. I hit a couple of buttons. I know. You've never heard it from a pastor. I know. I know. I know. I just lost a couple of people right now. I know. They never coming back. I know. I know. I know. I know. I know. It hurts. It hurts. I know. It hurts. I know. I know. It hurts. They're not coming back. I know. I know. I know. So understand that. That's the thing that we do. We look down on people when they sin differently. But it's still sin. It's a different form of sin. But it's still sin. Drug, food, it's a form of high. So understand that. And it's all rooted in lack of discipline. And you're using it to escape. Understand that. But society respects you. You could gain respect by being a food addict. But they look down on you if you're a drug addict. But you can fool society, but you can't fool God. You can't fool God. So now I'm letting you know, you can't be a disciple of Jesus Christ without discipline. Understand that. That's where the root word come from. You have to have discipline in order for you to be a disciple of Jesus Christ. You need to be disciplined. And that goes in every single aspect of your life. So understand that. So whatever the escape is, if it's not glorifying God, it's a sin. It doesn't matter if it's food. It doesn't matter if it's pornography. It's a sin. So what are you using to escape? There's a spirit behind it. And it's the same thing also with music. So there are spirits behind those music. Mm-hmm. So understand that. That is why I don't listen to songs that's not glorifying God. Because I know that energy that you're getting to clean the whole house, there's a spirit behind that. There's nothing for free in the spiritual realm. So now you got that energy from it. Now you made an alignment with that spirit. So the spirit that this song is promoting is now in alliance with you. You just made a covenant. So be careful. Where are you getting your energy from? What are you coming in agreement with? So that is why it is important. Is I need to glorify God. I need to represent God in everything that I do. The songs that I listen to. The movies that I watch. I've sat down and watched a series on Netflix. And it got my attention because a couple of the main characters were Haitian. I'm like, okay, I'm in. Let's go. 5 minutes into the series, a huge sex scene. All right. You know, sex is a part of life. All right. 5 minutes later, another sex scene. Wait a minute. Okay. 5 minutes later, another sex scene. I said, I'm out. I'm out. Now you're saturating it. You're using it now. You're using it now. You're saturating the content with sex. I'm out. You have to learn to say, I'm out. So you are listening to, you're in a conversation. You see that person is going towards a direction. You got to be, I got to go. That person that's all about that gossip. It's like you walk away, you feel spiritually depleted. It's like, you know what? I'm not going to keep doing that. Every time I get on the phone with this person, that's the route that I go. You know, I push the Holy Spirit aside. I'm bad-mouthing people. I'm bad-mouthing this person. I got to go. You got to learn to walk away from certain situations when you see that God is not being glorified in it. You got to learn to walk away from certain situations when you see that it's taking you to a dark path. Hey, I got to go. I got to go. I don't feel the presence of God in here. I got to go. Don't just go along for the ride. You're in that group conversation, you know, it start getting explicit. We start swapping sex stories. I got to go.
Amen.
I got to go. I got to go. Don't go along for the ride. Don't feel the need to fit in. That's the mistake that Christians make. We have a need to fit in.
Yep.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego did not fit in. Well, everyone else was bowing down to Nebuchadnezzar. They said, no, we will not bow down to you. You could throw us into the fire. And that's the problem every Christian is making. We have a need to fit in. Look at the Muslims. Look at the Muslims. They're not trying to fit in with anybody. They dress different. They praying 5 times a day. Look at my beautiful Christian sisters. What are you guys doing? You dressing just like the world. You see Instagram models and they have scriptures on their profile. And you're naked. That don't go. You look just like the world.
Right.
How you represent Jesus and you look just like everybody else?
Facts.
So that's the mistake we made. We have a need to blend in. Why are you blending in? God called you to stand out. You're supposed to stand out with your language. You're supposed to stand out with how you carry yourself. You're supposed to stand out. Don't try to fit in. We want to be accepted so bad. We want to be cool so bad. Why? It's okay. It's okay for people not to like you. That's good. The devil's not supposed to like you.
Amen.
The devil's not supposed to like you. So now if the devil's looking at the way you dress and do and give you a thumbs up, yeah, you messed up. If the devil's listening to your conversation and giving you a thumbs up, you messed up. If you're in a relationship and the devil's smiling at that relationship going, yeah, you messed up.
That's amen.
And a lot of you, the devil is smiling and giving you the thumbs up in every single aspect of your life. So make the decision. I represent God. I'm supposed to upset the devil. Amen. The world is not supposed to be comfortable with me. I stand with God till a casket drop. And once you start moving like that, that's how other people are going to get converted. They're going to see, okay, this is for real. This is real.
Amen. Amen.
Just like the Nebuchadnezzar when he saw Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego refuse to bow down. And now look at this spineless Christians now. They align with everything pop culture put out. So, you know, a child have the right to change their sex. You know, it's freedom of right. Spineless Christians. I could respect that. I could respect that. Yes. Free freedom of rights. I could respect that. Worthless. Spineless. Understand that. You're not supposed to fit in. You're not supposed to come in agreement with the world. They supposed to not like you. They supposed to hate you. And when you stand your ground, that's how you are going to convert people. That's how you are going to inspire people.
Amen.
Not kowtowing to their way of thinking. Not kowtowing to their belief system and how they're living. You're not helping. So today, represent the kingdom in everything that you do. And God will use you to save the lives of the people you come across. Not just while you're living, but your life and legacy will save souls long after you are gone.
Amen. Amen.
That's the life you should be aspiring to live. And that's our word for today. God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. That's our word for tonight. That's our word for tonight. So if you have not joined the prayer group community, do so. As soon as we finish this live, go in our DM. DM us and say, I want to join the prayer group community. So understand that it's not enough for you to get a sermon once a week. Do you eat once a week? So your soul can be fed once a week.
Amen.
Okay? Okay? So you don't eat once a week. So you need to be fed spiritually daily. So Amen. Go ahead and DM us and join the prayer group community.
Yes.
All right?
Facts.
So as my job as a pastor to keep you inspired, it's my job as a pastor to keep you motivated because the devil's afraid of that. You notice how much you struggle to read the Bible? You get sleepy. You get tired. He's afraid of that excitement. He's afraid of that enthusiasm. So he know he got it. You got it right now. But he's like, you know what? I'm going to make sure that it's gone in a day or two. But now if you are in a community of believers, you in this ministry, the Holy Spirit is going to use me to make sure that doesn't happen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
The Holy Spirit will use me to keep you inspired every single day. And that's what the prayer group community is all about. Remaining fully on fire for God. So now it's my job to keep throwing woods, keep throwing logs into that fire, keep fanning that flame, keep fanning that flame. So now the devil doesn't have authority over you. The devil can't discourage you. The spirit of depression can't penetrate now because you are living for God wholeheartedly and you are on fire. You are on fire. So go ahead and DM us. DM us right now and say, I want to join the prayer group community. So you could remain inspired. So you could remain motivated.
Amen.
So a lot of you have been going in circle for too long. Because you have gotten distracted. You've gotten spiritually lazy. Now it's time for you to align with God. So God could move through your life. So you can get the elevation and the blessing that you're supposed to get. God is not going to bless spiritual immaturity. Those of you who are parents, you're not going to give a mature kid the keys to your car. You're not going to do it. The kid could go, I have a license. Well, good for you. You're not getting in my car. Because you see that kid doesn't have that maturity.
Amen.
So it's the same thing. God is not going to give you that blessing, that miracle, if he see that you're not ready. It's like you keep waving back and forth, flip-flopping. You know, 1 minute you up, 1 minute you down. 1 minute you passionate. 1 minute you complacent. 1 minute you on fire. 1 minute you cold. 1 minute you hot. 1 minute you lukewarm. Absolutely not. So join the prayer group community. It is my job, my duty, my obligation to keep you inspired, to keep you motivated.
Amen.
And for you to continue on elevating and growing. Hallelujah. And that's our service for tonight, y'all. That's our service for tonight. Our time is up. Our time is up. We got Gospel Request Live coming back. When is Gospel Request Live coming back, woman of God? And then we got Bible study on Zoom with the prayer group community. Woo! We go in. Nothing is off limits. You know, we talk about sex from a biblical perspective. You know, what are the sexual what is accepted by God? What can you do in the bedroom when you're married? What is accepted when you are married? As a Christian, what are the do's? What are the don'ts? Can I do this? Can I do that? The things that the other pastors don't touch, I touch all of it. We cover all of it. So understand that. Jesus, God said, my people are destroyed due to lack of knowledge. So I made sure everyone in the community do not have that problem. We are fed with understanding and knowledge. So Wednesday, we have Bible study on Zoom at 8:30. Yes, woman of God, at 8:30 on Zoom. Wednesday, we have Bible study. And then when are you coming back, woman of God, for Gospel Request Live?
It's been I've had some difficulties getting through to, you know, get.
We have a lot going on, by the way. We're about to open the church very soon. Nice. We got a nice church. Woo! If you are in the Tri-State area, join us. We're about to open a church in September. Yes, Sister Jacqueline is in the prayer group community. She knows nothing is off limits. Nothing. We talk about everything and we back it up with scripture. So understand that. DM us. Join the prayer group community. All right. So we got Bible study again Wednesday, 8:30. And then discipleship class. We teach everything. We teach how to evangelize to other people. We speak about, educate on religion, the origin of it, the doctrine of it. We cover everything, the spirits behind the entertainment industry, what spirit is behind which song, spiritual contracts that goes in the entertainment industry. I'm a producer, television writer, so understand I can teach and educate in a way that very few pastors can. Hallelujah. So that is why so many people in the prayer group community are getting their breakthrough, are getting their elevation, because spirits are being exposed and they really getting that knowledge and that understanding. So everything about us is different. Our style is preaching is different. Our teaching is different. So everything about the ministry is different. So go ahead and DM us. And again, we have Gospel Request Live coming back tomorrow.
Yes.
Tomorrow what time?
Night. Tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night, as in Monday. All
yes,
right?
Yes.
As in Monday.
Actually, it's tonight, right?
Tonight, yeah. But some people, you know, to me, it's not tomorrow until I go to sleep. I don't care what time is it. You know, it's not tomorrow until I go to sleep. So what time tonight?
That's going to be tentative between 8 and 10. Just look out for the notifications. Yeah,
like I said, she's Haitian, so trying to get an exact time from a Haitian, that's very difficult. We're going to keep her in your prayers. So she said between, you can catch her between 8 and 10, all
yes,
right?
Pray for me, please.
Yeah, between 8 and 10, all right? So Gospel Request Live tomorrow with DJ Majesty between 8 and 10. And then we have Zoom Bible study with the prayer group community. DM us. You got to be in the ministry for you to come on the Zoom. So go ahead and DM us and join the prayer group community. And that's our service for tonight. That's our service for tonight. You guys have been awesome.
Life travel said Haitian time.
Hey, Martina, I see you, woman of God. I see you. So that's our service for tonight, guys. Again, the church is going to open on in September. It's a beautiful church. You know, God blessed us. It's a beautiful church. We have our own building. Church is going to open this September. It's in Long Island. And the parking is very spacious. You know, the place could hold about, I think, like, it looked like about a couple of hundred people.
Elmont, Long Island.
Elmont, Long Island. All right. So anybody in the Tri-State area, you'll be able to come and find parking. And there's plenty of space for social distancing. Beautiful church. All right. So get ready for that. And again, DM us. Yes, finally. Tita, finally catch the service. The end of it, though. So the church is going to open in September, and join us. We're going to have the ads coming out this week. All right. We're going to have the promos and the ads coming out this week for the church. Beautiful church. It sits about 200 people and parking space. I have a counseling office. You know, I do counseling, marriage counseling, single counseling, you know, grief counseling. So we're going to have room to do what we do. All right. Awesome. I'm so excited. God is moving in a monumental way. So go ahead and DM us. Join the ministry. Join the prayer group community. And DJ Majesty will be back. tomorrow night for Gospel Request Live, where you'll be able to order all the gospel songs around the world. So name it, she will play it, and you'll be able to dance, worship. So get excited about that. Gospel Request Live is back tomorrow. And then I have Bible study on Zoom. So for those of you who are in the ministry, so go ahead and DM us and join the ministry. So I send inspirational messages on a daily basis on WhatsApp. So go ahead and join us. And then we have discipleship class on Saturday, 8 p.m. And then, of course, I'm a trained Christian counselor. All my counseling sessions are absolutely free. I do not charge. All my counseling sessions are absolutely free. I do not charge. All right. So all of that comes absolutely free. All of our services are completely free. All right. So DM us, join the ministry, and look out. I will have the church information very soon. The ads are coming. It's a beautiful church. Oh, God is moving in a monumental way. Amen. And that's our service for tonight. Amen. Have a Holy Spirit filled week. God bless you and your family. Good night.
Have a blessed night. And see you tonight for praise and worship. Have a blessed night.